Hello, everybody. Welcome to me forgetting to change the Twitch room name. Yeah, basically, we tried the Game Shark thing, but but it turns out, yeah, it's... It's structured in a way that once they're in season mode, it's locked out, so I guess Arcade and Alco are going to be losing to the Dudley boys like over and over again. But once we're done season mode, we can fix it, so see where we go with that. Also let me know if the volume mixing's good and all that jazz.
We don't want to talk to Batista. We've seen enough of him the past couple of weeks.
Yeah.
It's that fucking sunny picture. I've had enough of this guy.
Yeah, exactly. Alright, so can we change shows yet? Okay, apparently we're still on a storyline. Whatever the storyline is, I have no idea. But... oh, we're fighting Dr. Wily.
Well, at least we're fighting somebody we can beat.
Yeah. And we've beat the default characters a couple of times now that we're getting better. That's one thing that this has over the previous game. Hold on a second. Okay, so I thought that this was our entrance for a second. I got very confused. Eric Bischoff wants you to get better acquainted with Batista and Triple H. That's what it's starting to feel like, because this... I think even Dr. Wily is now affiliated with Batista and Triple H.
Which is bizarre.
Yeah. But...
the leader of the Matt Furnaces, chuu.
Oh yeah. He'll break everybody's legs, and that's a promise. I basically skipped that part because he does the same thing like 8 more times. But... Alright, so... I've been playing so much Def Jam that I once again forgot the controls for this game.
L2 to reverse the strike, R2 to reverse the grapple, X to do strikes, circle to do grapples. I think square is the action button, triangle is the learn button.
L2's counter strikes?
Yeah, L2 strikes, R2's for grapples.
Okay. Seem to be doing us any favors right now, but come on, get up. Oh, come on. Enough of this. God. How is... all right. What? Has Batista and Triple H been training this guy?
Probably.
There we go. We hurt his head. That'd be cool if, like, they had, like, a story mode with the custom characters and they would just kind of level up by themselves.
That would be too easy for WWE.
Yeah. What? Taunt to gain momentum. Whoa! On. Yeah, there we go. One. All right, we got it now. Wait, this might still be a rope break. Wait, no, no, no. All right.
His hair's not quite in the ropes.
Wow, okay.
Squashed.
Yeah, no kidding.
Yeah, just taunt him.
Oh, yeah, yeah. There we go. After that performance, he deserves a taunt. Hey, attacking Earl was not in the description there. Uh-huh. That was him taunting?
Yeah, taunt is just you do your end of match taunt.
Ah. I thought he was gonna, like, talk smack to him or something. So, damn, I accidentally skipped it, but I have a feeling we'll be able to see it again. Oh no, Piper! I don't know, JR, what did happen to it?
No help, Piper. I think we owe him money.
Oh, wait, crap. Well, we played that guy on Always Sunny, though. We gotta help him. Also, you know, Goldberg's fighting him, and we don't like Goldberg right now, so. Why does he look like he's about to start crying?
I don't like that guy.
Alright.
We're in Manchester. New Hampshire.
Who do we have to talk to here? Thankfully it's not just Batista again. Alright, so we need a lot more speed than we have. Oh, also submission for the boost it up. Huh.
Oh, hell.
Booker T versus the wall. Alright, so almost every time a diva pops up, I'm not sure who it is. I'm playing the game right now. I mean, I know DMX said it ain't no game, but
I thought it was not a fucking game.
Well, yeah, it's, I mean, it's not one of those, no. He also was only in one game because of royalty disputes, but right. Ah, here we go. I'm secretly Stone Cold, okay? You don't want any of this.
Drop him from a forklift. That usually solves Stone Cold's problems.
Yeah. We did have a forklift there. Wow, he countered that. That was just a lot of stuff not landing there. We're already in yellow health, so that's good. With every passing match, the Shao Kahn comparison seemed more and more accurate. What? Okay, we're in red now. He hit us like maybe three times? Like, what the hell was that? So, of course, this was the guy that, Triple H here was the guy that didn't want any shots of him getting hurt and game shots, right?
For like SmackDown vs. Raw 2011, yeah.
Yeah. I feel like that explains a lot because it seems impossible to hurt him in this game. Is he in red already? What? Okay. Yep, we're in yellow too. I'm glad New Hampshire is where all these bullshit impossible matches happen. Also, Piper's just kind of oddly really slow for some reason.
Well, he's kind of old.
Good job. That rope break, maybe? Yeah. We're actually less hurt than Roddy Piper, strangely.
No.
The stream started,
little after 9.
Yeah, like 12 minutes ago. We'd started a little bit late because we were running into some trouble, technicalities and stuff. Yeah, Twitch is kind of weird like that. It doesn't really update things very fast. You know, after playing so much Def Jam and seeing how much Fat Joe spams the pedigrees, it just feels like I'm fighting him now. Hopefully he has a finish right here. Yeah, there we go. Bam! Wow, that looks like a Tekken punch there. How does he have? All right, he just has another one. That's cool. Maybe I am fighting Fat Joe. He's just in disguise right now. I can't counter any of this. I call my partner in? Why is he not coming out? Hey, you. Wanted to pull him away, but I guess that'll work too, I suppose. No, I don't really see a lot of tap outs happening in this game, strangely.
They happen, like, very rarely.
Yeah. I think, like, yeah, that meter was introduced, but now they're, like, almost impossible to actually do. I want to tag him in. And he's got the pedigree again. I can't seem to call in my partner at all. Alright, so that wasn't working for some reason. Left stick up, left stick. Wait, do I have a left stick up? Crap, I don't think I do. Hold on. Yeah, sure, whatever. That'll be it now. Okay, the game didn't freeze up. I was just checking my controls. Ah, it got really loud. It's time to play the game, unless Triple H is overpowered. Which he always is. Because we have to fight him every 5 seconds! Last night I had a vision. It was the same vision I had every night that I made a schedule based on it. Thanks, Vince! Is going to be Triple H, Batista, and Goldberg in this match. He just steps out and answers, I want to go to the other show. Let's just go for it, right? Or what do we do here? Why is he about to start yelling at us there? Alright, so Ohio. Hey, it's Piper again. Fun fact, before we started, there was a cutscene with him. But this might be the same cutscene. Oh wait, no, it's not. It's like, I just know who's gonna be in this match. No, I don't want to talk to Triple H! Wait. Is the Elimination Chamber supposed to be this month? Because it hasn't happened?
Yeah, it's supposed to be this month, I think.
Okay. And of course, we get to fight Triple H again. Every time he shows up, it is my exact reaction.
No fun allowed in this game.
Yeah.
I Triple H here.
I wasn't a Motorhead fan to begin with, but now I really don't want to hear another Motorhead song in my entire life anymore. Because as soon as I hear any of their music now, I'm just going to be picturing Pedigrees endlessly.
More so than if you heard Fat Joe music?
Yes. Because I was able to beat Fat Joe. Here he goes.
Is he already pedigree? Or are you just going on his tear already?
He's just going on a tirade. Like, once he starts a grab, like, we just won't be able to counter for like a half hour. Also, strangely, for some reason, our momentum is just not going up as much as we're doing this right now. No. Come on, it's not working all of a sudden!
Yeah.
What now?
What? Oh no, just fell off balance.
As soon as he does like two pedigrees in a row, I'm quitting this match.
At that point, it might as well just be done.
Sorry?
At that point, it might as well just be over.
Yeah. I could do that too. Oh, right, we have a finisher now, except, right, ours is a standing one. So, eat it! I guess we're too far away, huh? Come on! Hey, you want some of this?
They're pushing Goldberg better in this game than they ever did in real life.
Yeah, I can imagine. What do you want, Dr. Wily? Look, he's attacking all of our teammates now.
Goldberg just really wants to see the world burn.
Yeah. It is truly a dark night for wrestling right now. Guess what Triple H has stocked? That's right, the Stone Cold Stunner. Okay, for some reason our left and right sticks just aren't working anymore. I was mashing at every button. At this point, any Triple H match, I'm just gonna skip. Because this is ridiculous. It's just gonna be the same thing every single time. And it's just getting really repetitive. I still like how we have, I like how it's even in the cutscene, too. That's what I want to know.
Ever end?
Alright, well, while this is going on, I'm gonna see what's up with the controller real quick, because I have no idea what's going on with the right and left sticks right now. They do not seem to be working. Let's see. Left, right, down. And then, let's try this. Up, left, right, down. Okay. That should work. This trailer is inaccurate. It only shows one pedigree. Well, the glue man is in here. Should we go for it, or...?
It's the Elimination Chamber, so...
we might actually have a chance. Let's see what happens. Who knows, maybe the glue man will, Yeah, that's the thing. Freakzilla is the custom character, so he'll always be losing. Oh, hey, look who we're fighting first. And for some reason, nothing is working. Wait, how is that already a two count? What is going on? Okay, that's just the way the Elimination Chamber then, I guess. But no, I didn't want to pin him again. Warning, I guess. I'm not gonna cheer this demon on. One of many demons. Just do it to somebody, I guess. Now you get out of here. This is actually the demon tournament for you, Hawk Show. It just has the glue man in it for some reason. The glue man could easily be from the demon world. Just keep Glue Man here till the end. I thought you meant Hard Eat Harness from the Demon World.
Which wouldn't be too far off the mark.
Yeah. So I like how the Battle Monsters is taking place in like the Demon World, but there's just like a guy there. Doesn't seem to be a monster or anything, he's just there. What button is closest again? Ah! This strategy seems to be working. Oh, oh, no, 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 no. Get off. You get away. So, Glue Man is out.
Batista's already in the orange.
Yeah, that's interesting. And now Triple H is here doing Triple H things. I couldn't keep my distance. As soon as he showed up, he just went right after me. Oh my god. Thank you, Goldberg. Get out of the corner. Oh my god, leave me alone! Even Goldberg is sick of him now. Also, it's interesting that Piper was like, hey, they're all gonna be after you, but they seem to be largely doing their own thing.
They're largely going after each other.
Yeah. They probably don't even have chuu here except for Triple H. Yeah, you get away from me. No. That's fine. That was just a weak pull of line. No.
The only people left in this match are you and the other state.
Yeah. No. We're in the yellow. No. Yeah, you help us. That's what your whole thing is. Yeah.
You can exit the ring.
Oh, yeah. Well, now we can't because... Oh yeah, we can do this too. Can we? Oh my god, we could have done this the entire time. Chu is just watching this, wondering where his life has led, how his life led to this. Oh god, yeah, Chu is kind of doing the gargoyle pose, like a KO Joe in Ring Rage. Let's go see how this pans out. Dr. Wily is banged up pretty bad. Then he's out. Oh god. Oh god, no. No! Well, the funny thing is about Chu looking like a Fist of North Star character is that they're probably based off of the same thing, which is Mad Max. Chu looks a lot like Vernon Wells' character in Mad Max.
Yeah, hell yeah.
No! What the hell kind of move was that, Batista? Let me get back to my chamber. That'll work. Oh wow, after that, he totally just ignored us. Well, Triple H has been defeated. That's for sure.
Yay!
Finally.
The evil is defeated.
Yeah. I mean, these two are still evil, but they're, like, less evil. They're like his henchmen, basically. Okay. The best part about this is that nobody can break up the pin now. Ah! Alright. He's gonna- No! No! Oh god, he's got his finisher now. We're done. He's the only survivor because his stats are way more than they should be. I'm gonna ask
Eric. Get the fuck out of Raw.
No wonder why nobody's watching Raw here. Oh my god! What? Yes, I completely thought it through and I hate every single thing about Raw right now. Yeah, good. Alright, so when does this take effect?
I think it takes place next week.
Okay.
Start next week, you and I are strangers. Bye!
Have fun! Yeah. I imagine Chu just like skipped out of the room with like both flipping the bird with both hands. Yeah, sure, whatever. Now get the cards from my Aren't we supposed to be in SmackDown? What's going on here?
Oh, next month.
Okay. I like how out of spite, now we're just not on the card. And hey, look, it's the Dudley Boys versus Alco and Arcade again. Oh wow, they lost again. Like, I can imagine Raw's audience in this universe right now is, like, almost nobody. Oh my god, they just keep fighting. Anymore.
I hate that they're making you wait a whole month.
Yeah. And it's like the same matches over and over on the card, too. Is this the new month then?
No, this is the end of the month.
Because I noticed it was still the Raw text. Ah, Triple H won again. Hey, Bubba Ray beat Batista though. I can get behind that at least. Huh?
Hell yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, that's fine, Stephanie. Let's hope Vince's daughter does a better job at, like, having an acceptable show than him. My god, that was miserable.
What?
Huh?
Huh?
What? No!
Is it going exactly 1 month from when you last asked?
I think that might be what's going on, yeah. Okay, yeah. Wait, what? Why are we just fighting Dan Reichert now? Sure. Hey, later. I have to say, Kurt Angle is a perfect fit for Dan just all around, somehow. I don't know what it is, but... I suddenly want to see Kurt Angle wearing the Waluigi outfit.
I feel like you're gonna make that happen somehow.
Do Fire Pro edit idea, maybe?
Maybe.
Yeah. Yeah, we still have Kmart Judgment to deal with. Hold on, dogs. Alright, I think the dogs are quiet now. Did we just anti-air Van there?
It's not an anti-air fart, but...
I might have to turn my game down a little bit, really quick, and there we go. So Dan's gonna be our last hurrah for this miserable, miserable card. It's like, you know what this card's the equivalent of? It's like that radio station that plays a total of like maybe like 10 songs a day.
It's like my work radio station that plays like 50 million pop songs, but then occasionally pulls out like I Want You by Savage Garden or Talking Heads.
Yeah.
Also, I'll be right back.
Alright. Middle fingers are directed towards Eric Bischoff. I just won't go down. I want this over so I can meet new people. Can't be that painful to you after how much you've drank. Alright. Oh god, it's that monster Goldberg. Get him out of here. It's possibly that other monster Triple H in his, Actually, that's not the color of his trunks at all. In this game, anyway. Oh, wow. Wow, Dan. Okay. Now get the cards, the charts from my generation. Okay. Alright, I gotta wait for Sasha for this. This is way too good. Way too much potential here.
Hey, I'm back.
Hey, so apparently we're gonna interview Dan.
Oh no.
Hell yes again. Oh no! I plan on being there if I'm, you know, if I'm brave enough.
It's a crapshoot. No.
I don't know what Glue Man would sound like. Mike Dawson was so confident in himself. And so after this, we're done with Raw?
I hope so.
Unless we're just stuck in raw hell.
They're fighting the wall.
Okay.
Fighting the wall, brother.
There's that elimination tag, though. I think we might have to watch that. We haven't seen this.
This is like when work plays, like, I want you, and then I need you tonight, and then, like, burning down the house right in a row.
Hold on, who's that?
That's Sean O'Hare, the Devil's Advocate.
I don't think I've ever heard of him.
He was a mid-aughts guy who unfortunately passed away, I think.
Oh, damn.
He was teamed up with Victoria for a while.
Huh. Hold on.
Also, probably one of the guys with, like, the coolest idea for a gimmick that never panned out because they never went through with it.
Oh, wait, I think you actually told me about that before.
The Devil's Advocate.
Yeah, yeah.
He was hypothetically supposed to, like, encourage wrestlers to do bad things.
I remember now. Yeah, that does sound really good.
That weirdo pervert Frank Yeager.
Had enough weirdo perverts in games. I'd ask who won the fight between him and Kukri, but it'd probably just be a slap fight. I kind of want to see that happen now, honestly. To see if anybody still has gotten on making Shinsuke here. Oh, hey! It seems like somebody did.
Huh. I think it's quite the same as ours, but...
Hey, when was this made? Oh, this was made a while back. I must have actually seen it. We don't need WWE heroines. Then again, if there was one, there'd probably be like no grapples or something like that.
It would be nothing but grapples.
Yeah. I'm just trying to come up with an equivalent to you can't crouch in a fighting game because I still cannot get over that.
You can't get on the top turnbuckle.
Yeah, that sounds pretty good too. Now, I always found it interesting how her 14 palette's different from her 13 one, even though it's roughly the same outfit. This is a perfect theme of being every time. But for a moment, Leona was actually going to beat Batista. Is that her new Orochi form? Orochi Lee. Well, now we gotta make Orochi Lee Chow Lane and call him Orochi Lee. Yeah, we gotta go, like, keep a list of all these ideas we have and just make a federation out of them. I probably could somehow make Orochi Lee Chalene in Tekken 7.
Might be possible.
Orochi's? I cannot wait to see what this guy does in the Royal Rumble.
Or what he fails to do.
Yeah.
Or the two.
Who knows, he might do his usual Rumble strats of winning. Because he's done that before. Also, I like how one team is just entirely SMK. That just kind of happened. No, no. One. Two.
With my 14 mains, the team.
Oh, yeah. Three. These games do kind of know, yeah. Vanessa's just doing her usual thing of going to work. On this guy. Oh my god!
Very nonsensical tag in.
Yeah! Don't really know what that was about, really. What? I never thought I'd see Mike Dawson doing the Gold Dust taunt before, but Psycho Ball! I'm gonna have to gif that later. Athena?
That one doesn't count because Mike Dawson did it.
Yeah, yeah. He did it while Athena like blue screens or something. I'm not really sure what that was about.
Psycho Buster.
Yeah. Also, somehow we got right back up after that. Oh yeah, this hold. Which looks a lot better in this game.
To some degree.
It's mostly because the hands aren't going through their neck or anything. Leave Chinsuke alone. No, you're supposed to do that when he... Is the Athena okay?
I'm not sure.
God, what a... What? You couldn't even...
Well, I've lost all sensibility in this match.
Yeah. This is like a comedy routine now.
Well, it is the opening match.
Yeah. Vanessa has two finishers stored up, as well as Shinsuke. Let's see what we got here. Oh, wow, the music kicked in when he did that.
Chainsaw!
Let Athena rest or something. She seems to be a bit out of it. I have expected her to just, like, during that animation, just fall.
Just kind of stood there and took that.
Yeah. These characters seem to be getting a bit confused in this match for some reason. Also, all three of those characters on that team did nutshots, huh?
Yeah. Kin Sasha.
What now?
The Kin Sasha.
Oh.
It's not quite a Kin Sasha.
I love when the AI messes up landing grapples.
Leona, you doofus, use your finishers.
Yeah, why is she not? Well, Vanessa's got three of them, so.
Anything and she has a charge character, she's not playing well. I've lost count of Shinsuke tonight.
Yeah, me too. I think that might have been the fifth one.
Everybody's doing everybody's doing nut shots as much as I've lost count.
Yeah. I love that the middle part is always in red when people are fighting him.
The Mary Dynamite swing.
That's a bit late there. Doesn't make the bar go on the screen. Oh no, now she's got the safety zone, is that what that's called?
Safe. Yeah.
You guys are the super again. One, two. That looks like an elbow drop and more like he just lost balance and happened to hit her around time.
He's slipping a banana peel.
What is Leona doing?
She's doing her best.
Oh my god. She has the pin and Earl's like, no, Leona's gonna go inside the ring. Before I count. Athena is just malfunctioning now. I think Athena bot may have replaced her for this match. That's another edit idea there. Oh, this song. You absolutely should be laughing, yeah.
Max cancel.
She combo grabbed out of that somehow. Six. Taking his time for some reason. Has her super bar. Possibly make AI like a female.
WrestleMania that came close with Mike Dawson.
Yeah.
At least in his first version.
I can't be waiting until she wasn't busy anymore to do that. Again, seems very Mike Dawson.
What? No, this match isn't over. It's elimination.
Oh, yeah, yeah. How does Mike keep getting these stealth wins? That, like, practically sounds like a gunshot when he hits with that.
Well, he's hitting with brass knuckles, so...
Yeah, but are they, like, loaded with shotgun shells or something?
Who knows, though.
One, two, three!
Oh my god! I think the brass knuckles are just super powerful somehow. He didn't feel like cocking the glory anymore.
He was too embarrassed.
I'd win, but I'm way too embarrassed.
Question marks. Freaking Sasa.
One, two. Finisher. That's what this has over Fire Pro. The AI actually has the sense to, like, put them in better places before they ping.
They do that sometimes in Fire Pro too. Sometimes.
Yeah. It's weird. Like, I think a lot of, like, the priority moves in Fire Pro kind of, like, make them stop after a while. It's like, I have to pin them now, like, wherever they are. Is he gonna take this? He had a good run.
Psycho headache.
Ate way too much ice cream. Athena, you're supposed to... What? Okay, that was... She was holding on to him telepathically there. Telekinetically. Probably both.
One. Two. Three.
Alright, well...
She was feigning stupidity.
Definitely seems it.
Load them into a false sense of security. Oh, right, we gotta play this game.
Oh, Hey, it's Truck Davis from Tattoo Assassins.
Ah, it's Chili McFreeze.
Oh, well. I'm so happy to see you. Every audience member saying I am a huge superstar gets a slot in whatever story I'm doing after this. The Wall takes off his mask and he's Triple H. Don't give me nightmares. I'm just imagining like the ending to Phantasm, except instead of the Thin Man being in the mirror, it's just Triple H. But he still goes, boy!
See, I'm picturing the bit from Being John Malkovich, which is like, Triple H, Triple H, Triple H, Triple H.
Oh my god, yeah, that's way more appropriate.
Triple H, Triple H.
The lead character loses his mind because he has to keep fighting Triple H. Yeah, I'm just imagining like a Triple H marionette, like they keep beating him up. I suppose it's not too far off from the actual wall. Damn, I'm the Wall.
How'd I get on top of this building?
What was that?
How'd I get on top of this building?
Every Duke Nukem line I say just has to start with damn. Like, I can't do it any other way. I'm gonna choke slam those alien bastards who shut up my ride. While I was on a building taunting Hulk Hogan. Hulk Hogan's more of a Shadow Warrior player than a Duke Nukem player. That is not surprising somehow.
He only played the original one.
Yeah. Yeah, old Shadow Warrior, because it says Hulk Hogan. Exactly. I just find the humor way more genuine in the old version, brother. Singer just seems to be like an angry, like, gorilla or something screaming into the mic.
Damn it, his hair was touching the roof.
Yeah. He just had the Earl somehow. Hopefully, Shin Hebner's probably in the other show, too.
I think so. Yeah.
I can only imagine that we'll just find some new other wrestler that we're sick of on the other show, but...
It'll probably be The Undertaker.
Yeah, probably. We can just keep, like, switching back and forth if necessary. Again, Stephanie seems way nicer than Eric, so who knows. We didn't buy ECW yet.
Wait, by this point they was.
Oh, really?
Yeah. They just hadn't brought it back.
Well, there's my Philly rep taken care of, which I guess it says a lot that ECWs are representative of wrestling. chuu got demoted from the Four Horsemen to ECW. Yeah, he's gonna have to keep fighting Booger over and over again. Wall, more like the floor.
He's ending up like his namesake right now because he sure is being torn down.
Yeah. And suddenly he like comboed us. That was a real Def Jam combo right there. By the way, after we're going Metal Bash, I'm considering possibly making the Def Jam story mode a thing.
One, two, three.
Yeah.
Respect.
Oh, damn it. Well, we didn't see the taunt before. We'll say we respected him afterwards.
Treating him to a beer.
Yeah, yeah. That's more like it. Also, we're not really disrespecting him, we're more just disrespecting Earl more than anything. Wait, he lost his glasses?
No, he takes them off when he's in the match.
Oh, yeah, yeah, that's right.
Sadly, this isn't WWF World War. Yeah.
Pour one out for my buddy the Wall. There you go. Got more over here if you want one. Get this Eric guy off of my screen. Booker T.
In an ultimate submission match, I should add.
Yeah, I was about to... Why are we still at Raw?
Is it because we started the Royal Rumble storyline?
Slot 30 is gonna be Triple H. Oh yeah, we should like get these up, get them right.
Get a bit more endurance, I think.
Yeah. Look, no, yes. 29 Triple H's and two? What the hell is that for?
Oh, Hurricane Elko finally fighting someone that isn't the Dudleys.
Yeah, we're gonna have to watch that just to see them do other things for once. Yeah, I realized it was the interview after I sat and looked at it for a bit, but it is a hell of a lineup for a four-way. Oh, no entrance is this time. Oh, no! Arcade is just watching. Also, I like at one point we had a storyline plot with Trish and then she just kind of stopped talking to us.
Yeah.
She's seeing Arcade now. That's the thing. I think Glacier's been on the floor for like most of this match right now. stunner on the chair. You! Oh god, was he really? I'm glad, I'm even happier that we transferred shows. Well, now we just need a handicap with like him and like five other ladies. Wait, she's just standing here watching. Oh no, not the Navigator, WWE Attitude Review again! You don't get to do that every day. Whatever game we do next, he's probably gonna have to end up being on the, George Woods, probably gonna have to end up being one of the characters. Imagine wrestling him, he would just like review the match that's going on while he's doing the match. For example, this character is way too hard to suplex. Don't even try it. I'm tempted to add the no-name characters from the WWF Attitude Review, but also that would probably look really weird out of context. I also like how all those characters had Stone Cold Steve Austin's voice. So one lady was like, oh, don't take it personal, son. Imagine George Wood as a commentator. That'd be pretty good. He calls himself The Undertaker, but he's not dressed reminiscent of any Undertaker that I know. What the heck? This guy looks like a biker. Lots of kicks. What? I hope you saw that. If not, you just missed a Glacier and Alco doing a dropkick and hitting themselves at the same exact time with it.
That's a clash.
Yeah.
Some melty blood shit.
Yeah. Alco, why do you keep doing that? Audience started chanting something after that. Alright, I'm getting the table. I think Alco has the advantage of this match because she has serious legs. She's in the same top tier as Dan and Vicky. Now what he'd say about Glacier is it's like, Glacier reminds us of somebody else that we've seen recently and he'll post a picture of Sub-Zero. He's like, aha! Yeah, that was it, because Alco kept running into a chair and then proceeded to stomp it. So there's that. Okay, alright, so... Rikishi. Every time I see the name Gabe Degrassi, I just keep thinking of that show Degrassi.
Yeah.
Huh?
Almost fell over again.
Oh. Well, on the bright side, if you fall over, you might be able to do a pretty cool looking elbow drop if Chinsuke is anything to indicate. That's how we saw this once, but we gotta watch it again because, I mean, really. Saw Dan Reichert's. Strangely, Jeff seems to have gone missing.
He's in New York. He's hanging out with Ben.
I mean, yeah, he's hey, whatever Wrestling Federation Ben's in now. Then where they play stuff like Doomsday Warrior all day. Jeff's entrance theme should just be the shadow theme from Doomsday Warrior. The first thing that Mike Dawson did was kick Earl in the face.
That seems natural for him.
Yeah. Oh no, I didn't mean to do that. What? No. Earl is the shapeshifter. That explains why Shin Hebner is a thing. We got you before. Well, this is more Sasha's roster. The one from last game was the one I made, but yeah, combined the two, we have a solid card. Honestly, I might be able to make whoever's missing for Fire Pro in due time, so we just have that.
I think, like, you probably have to make chuu.
No, I already made chuu.
Oh.
Actually, a friend made the appearance for him, and I gave him the moves from that 120% game. Actually, the funny thing is, I went down a list of, like, you know, the characters in each thing that he did and who needs to be made and who doesn't. This is actually the one where most of the work is actually already done.
Huh.
Because there is an Arino, there is a Dr. Wily, of course there's a Mike Dawson, there's Blue Man, Alco, and strangely, Arcade was also made.
That I didn't know about.
I feel like just making your version as Jeff, just to see how that, like, kind of, like, acronym generated moveset would come out in Fire Pro. But also, he has already been made as well.
By me.
Yeah. Warren was made, but he doesn't look quite right. Like, he's kind of looks more like a sumo wrestler in that version. He does have the drop kicks, though, I can attest to that. He even does the sound, so. Hell, even a bwah was made. That looks more like a portrait art than the in-game art. They look like completely different characters. Actually, Actually, I think I should have the list somewhere. I don't know exactly where I put it, but... And we'd probably have to remake Shinsuke because he wouldn't play anything like this version.
Yeah. Less slow blows.
Yeah. You get out of here. Oh, wait. I got so distracted I thought I was playing as Mike Dawson. But this is a custom roster, so we should be fine. Unless Mike Dawson somehow, like, beats us, too. Oh shit, wait a minute. Ah, that wasn't the elimination. Like,
well, Dan gets to pick his number, I guess.
Yeah. Alright, let's see what happens here then. Probably be like, well, I'm gonna be the, like, almost last. Oh, chuu, you bastard! You know this wrong. Well, wrong. Just wiping the grease off. Well, chuu, the guy who I said would be a stranger. Yeah, that's a good point. we don't have any experience with him. We're fighting Dr. Wily again. Does it matter if we skip it? I mean, like...
I don't know.
Oh, let's see what Arino versus Miney will look like real quick. That's a hell of a picture of McMahon there. I just noticed one of them is just holding up a sign that says sexy and nothing else. Pose looks so much like a sprite you would have. Okay, so Eeny Miney was one of the characters that hasn't been made for Fire Pro yet.
It'd be a bit difficult to make, I think.
What was that?
She'd be a bit difficult to make, wouldn't she?
Maybe you probably have to do like the really big legs for the skirt, but otherwise it'd probably be easy. That and I did make a moveset for her in WWE 2K19, but I couldn't just use this one. Also, September 15th, 2018, still no Bob Hoskins Mario in the workshop.
I've seen a Bob Hoskins Mario referee on the PS4 workshop with a weird big head for something.
It's probably the Punch-Out reference there. He just has a ladder now. Thank you. Oh, this is a ladder match, isn't it? I wasn't really paying attention to the match types here. Ow. This is a ladder match. It's taking a great time actually getting it set up. Hey guys, what's going on? I will miss seeing the money. Look. No! Well, I disagree.
I know he's not the smartest man in the world.
He's going at that as well as his plan to beat Intelligent Cube. That's the second time he set the ladder and then figured out that it wasn't going right back to his line. What is she doing?
Is she getting another ladder or is she getting a table?
For some reason. Well, why is he setting it up there? And why is he scared of him?
Did he even need scared of ladders? Is this what the game is trying to tell us right now?
I think so. Ladders are just, like, scary. She was just trying to slap him out of the air. I thought she was going for the pin. It's like, for a ladder match, they're not really going for the ladder very much, it looks like. Why you bring the table in? Hey, listen to it. Oh. Okay. Too. Okay. Alright, now get the ladder. It's the ladder. Great job, Beanie.
They just lost sight of this entire match. Again.
Yeah. Well, I did my work for the day. I'm back to her hobby of grabbing a sledgehammer. The ladder. You got your finisher, so let's... Alright, so get the ladder. Damn it, Eddie. Yeah, she... Yeah, it's, someone drove a car into the ladder while she was jumping. Oh, no. Table. Now she's gonna do it. Oh wow, she actually like broke his face there.
Slapped the cooling pad right off of him.
So that was a cooling pad this entire day, at time, I had no idea.
Yeah.
I thought he just, like, gassed his forehead at one point. I guess if he did, we'd never know. Alright, so Ari, where'd you get the... There we go. Possible. Is there any other way to like redo it aside from just like throw it and then pick it back up? I guess what
I
could afford.
I don't remember.
Yeah, great placement there. He actually hurt himself more than he ever did, right? Okay, so... And she might get it! Yeah! That was ridiculous.
Now get the cards! The cards from my
Let's get this. accident. Yeah. Okay.
Time for the Royal Rumble. This would probably be a good place to end it, too.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I can't imagine who we're gonna have in this. Over the, Now it's Dan! I like how we're now rivals with Dan Reichert. Where's this dramatic Soul Calibur music here? Don't care. Don't care. Play. Well, you're not making any noise. What the? Oh! I haven't seen him in a while.
Might be on SmackDown, I bet.
Sorry?
Might be on SmackDown.
Now we got Rikishi, so yeah, I imagine we are. This is a theme now? That's a radical change from what I used to. He's just used to the too cool theme attached to him. Oh, he is still with Scotty Too Hot at this point. Okay. Hey.
Just gonna get all the real people out of the way.
Yeah. I was about to say, but Rikishi's in that way. Oh, Foo Fighters is here!
And Rhino's gone.
Alright, well, that, we're gonna be chuu, so. Or number five. Who is also chuu. So. Yeah. Good lineup so far. Oh no! But Mike Dawson's still here. Oh yeah, yeah, he. Yeah. I like how the music just stopped. But he got Foo Fighters out. Oh no 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 no! We don't need to be losing this as quick. Oh hey, Hans. I like how both of them failed to get Leona out there. Except Mike got it. Mike eliminated two people. How is he, like, this secretly good? Mike Dawson is OP somehow.
I mean, he is a fire pro.
Yeah. Hey, Jeff!
Back from New York.
Yeah. Oh god, he's targeting us.
Giant Bomb's gonna beat with,
Oh no! D for two now?
Yeah, Giant Bomb's gonna beat with you, Hawk Show.
Yeah. No! We're out. At least we get to watch whatever's going on here.
Not in a while, yeah.
Subordinate of Triple H. Hey, China! Oh, wow, we can actually play his character. Okay, I'm gonna play as China. I probably should have played as Jeff, actually, because of his moveset, but... Come on, it's China. Figure out how to actually throw them out because I'm having a bit of trouble with that.
You just kind of got to be close to the ropes, aim for the ropes.
Like, do I just hit circle and nothing else or what?
Yeah. Dan, for some reason, picked number 15, I guess.
It's an unexpected number.
Dan would refuse 29 and go for 50.
Alright, Jeff is out. Damn it. Oh, that'll work too.
It's Ultimate Dragon.
Yeah, he's got it there.
That's basically how his WWE work was, just kind of there.
Also, he's got the Motaro theme.
Oh,
it's Tajiri.
Suddenly got really real wrestler in here. But these are all cool real wrestlers, so I'll take it.
It's Iron Sheik.
In the Japan portion of this roster.
And Nikolai Volkov.
So who is he again?
Basically Iron Sheik's like best friend. One of the most well-known Russian wrestlers of all time.
Oh god, it's Lightstorm. We just had like kind of a couple of real wrestlers, fake wrestlers, now we're just at the real ones. But I don't mind any of these. And this Christian. I'm trying to get up, thank you. There's the Devil's Advocate. It'd be okay if we won this as China. Make her the champion. Something tells me we might not be able to do that, though. No! Get over there! I do think I know you.
Yeah, minor rank number 25.
Oh, it's that guy I replaced in the Dudley Boys that one time. That's how I remember him now. That'd be pretty cool. Oh god, this theme. I mostly just associate it with the WCW Thunder entrances now. Because I would just hear the intro and then it would just stop.
RVD.
One left. No! Damn it! Alright, well, who's left at least? Ah, so close.
Number 30, Vince McMahon's big surprise, Bubba Ray Dudley.
You know, that guy that kept showing up over and over and over again. Once again, Rob Van Dam's the champion.
I don't think he's the champion. This is like the main event shot, basically. Mm. This is the guaranteed title shot.
Oh, he won a big thing.
Can we go to another show?
Yes, please. Ah, oh, thank God.
So yeah, I guess we just got stuck on Raw because we were locked into the Royal Rumble storyline, I guess.
Yeah, so Stephanie kept us there. Alright, we ended it. Oh, well, actually, yeah, it is almost exactly 2 hours, so this would be a good time to call it. Alright, this theme is certainly something, though. Alright, well, we escaped the nightmare of Triple H, so, I'd say this was a success.
But who knows? Undertaker might be around the corner.
Yeah, well.
Or whoever the World Heavyweight Champion is in this universe.
Yeah. We'll find that out next week, though. Till next time, thanks everybody for watching. Thanks, Sasha, for everything.
No problem.
And we'll see you next week. See ya.
See ya.